Convection is a method of heat transfer. In this method, this is a very natural method. In this method, let's take one example. Here are many molecules and this is fluid. In the fluid, there is a facility that molecules can move if they have energy. The binding between the molecules is not very large. Therefore, if they want to move, they can move with little energy. Here, we apply a source of heat and heat it. The molecules which are here, these molecules get heated up. When they get heated up, there is an expansion. And when the volume increases, the density decreases. So, what we are doing first? Heat. What this heat is doing? Expansion. Expansion. With the expansion, what happens? Volume increase. With this volume increase, what happens? Density decrease. With the density decrease, what happens? Buoyancy and particle lifted up. When the particle lifts up, then what happens? Vacuum created. This vacuum created is filled up by particles from sides. The sides are filled up from far off or top particles. Okay, now this sequence, see here, we heat it up and these many particles, they expand. When they expand, their volume increase. When the volume increase of the same mass, the density decrease, they become lighter. When they become lighter, then due to the buoyancy force, because they are lighter like wood in the water, they rise up. So these are rising up this way. When they rise up, two actions take place. Vacuum is formed here, and when they are rising up, their temperature become lower because they come in contact with this. So here, if the temperature is higher by 10 degree, by the time they reach here, the temperature is higher by 1 degree. 10 to 1, because they are giving certain heat here and they are reaching here. But they go up. When they go up, then vacuum is created at this location. Here, when vacuum is created, who fills it up? These particles come here from the sides. And if here vacuum is created, these particles come here. These particles come here. These particles come here. Now, these were 10 degree higher. By the time they reach here, they are only 1 degree higher and they are here. Now, the particles which are coming here, they get heat by this. Again, these are heated up and they move up. When they move up, they push them here. Because these are hotter than this. So they push them and they come to the side. And then they will come down to fill up the vacuum. And here what we get is that the water keeps on moving like this. The fluid keeps on moving. This is fluid. This may be liquid. This may be vapors. This may be gases. Now, these are the currents due to heat energy. And these currents, what's happening in this? You see, this is having a temperature, say 10 degree. This become 50 degree. They go on the top. The next one come, become 50 degree, go here. The next one come, become 50 degree, go up. So every particle for getting heated up has to come here, take its own heat and move. So the heat to the other particles are not given by this, by the neighbors. every particle has come to the source, take his own part of heat and move. So this is the way convection. So what is, where is the basic difference in conduction? This is giving heat to it, this is giving heat to it, and source is giving heat to this continuously. And in convection, what happens? This will take heat, go, this will take heat, go, this will take heat, go, this will take heat and go. This is happening in convection. And because there is a movement of the particles, this movement makes a current, this cycle. And here is the source of energy. So in this way, in convection, the heat is distributed, but at the same time, we get the particles making a current. This is known as convection current. And now we are in this position to write what is convection method. In method of convection, so this is the method of making convection currents. So this current we see in very small things, and we also see largely in the nature. Okay, where because of these convection currents, the world has movement. We can say the system of nature on our earth that is working. These convection currents we see, and these are the reasons for rains. Everywhere, all over the earth, if there are no rains, there is no life. And the rain are because of this convection. So the life is because of this convection current. You see, how do we dig? The method of rain, we can explain like this, that most of the earth is made of sea, water, and some part of it is landmass. Now in the daytime, when there is sun and heat is there, this gets heated up. Landmass get heated up fast, sea gets heated up slow. So here the air particles get heated up fast and move up. When the air particles move up, there is a vacuum created here, and the air here on the sea move towards landmass. This is happening in the daytime, and it goes up, gets cooled up, and it can come down here. So this is the convection current in the morning, in the daytime, from sea to land. And in the night it will be reversed, because in the night land will radiate out heat and become cool. The water will remain hot. At that time the air will go up here and it will come from here, and this will be reversed. This is day and night convection. There are convection from season to season. In one particular season, when there is a lot of sun here, and that area of the earth, suppose this area of the earth get heated up compared to this area. Say if this is hot and this is cool, we get a current on the earth, on the ground like this, and in the sky like this, on the ground like this, on the sea like this. So what will happen? We will have these ships here. The ships will move, the ships will sail along with the air, and they will come here. Then after 6 months, this gets hot, this gets cool. Then there will be air in the opposite direction, that is from cool place to hot place, cool to hot. The air always goes from cool to hot. So after 6 months, the direction of air will be in this way, and the ships will sail back. This was the method of doing business, trade, in the earlier times when the ships used to sail Europe to India, China, and from India and China Sea back to Europe. 6 months one side, 6 months other side. So those were the convection currents. So our climate, our seasons, because of the convection current in the atmosphere. So there are so many uses, so many places, so many applications of the convection current this way. So this is about the convection. In the next lecture, we will study about radiation, that is the third system of transfer of heat. Thank you.